Hi friends, this podcast is about Budget 2020 highlights. The Finance Minister of India, Nirmala Sitharaman, on Saturday unveiled the budget for the fiscal year 2020-2021. This was done in a bid to boost income of Indians and their purchasing power. And this was done in a bid to revive the economic growth that has slumped to the lowest in the last decade. Before we get into the key highlights, I will recommend that after listening to this podcast at any suitable time in the day or later, you should listen to this podcast again so as to imbibe well the key highlights from Nirmala Sitharaman's budget speech. So, here we go. Number one key highlight is taxation. There has been a new optional tax slab. The new income tax slab will be available only for those who forgo exemptions. Therefore, if you earn up to 5 lakh, there is no tax. But if you earn over 15 lakh, you are taxed a whopping 30%. And then there are other rates of taxation. For example, if you earn between 5 to 7.5 lakh, your tax rate is 10%. If you earn between 7.5 lakh to 10 lakh, your tax rate is 15%. If you earn between 10 lakh to 12.5 lakh, your tax rate applicable will be at the rate of 20%. And if you earn between 12.5 lakh to 15 lakh, the tax rate applicable shall be 25%. Earlier, when the company used to pay dividends to its shareholders, it used to pay dividend distribution tax to the government. Now, dividend distribution tax is charged at the hands of recipients at applicable rates, not the companies. Number three key highlight. Tax on cooperative societies has been reduced to 22% without exemptions. Key highlight number four. The finance minister made a very bold statement, which was to end tax harassment. New taxpayer charter is to be instituted. And she said, tax harassment shall not be tolerated. Key highlight number five. Government shall be launching new direct tax dispute settlement scheme called Vivad Se Vishwas scheme, which translates to from conflict or dispute to confidence scheme. And interests and penalty will be waived for those who wish to pay the disputed amount of tax till March 31st. Key highlight number six. Aadhaar-based verification of taxpayers is to be introduced to weed out dummy or non-existent units. Instant online allotment of PAN on basis of Aadhaar shall be implemented. Key highlight number 7 comes from housing. Tax holiday for affordable housing extended by 1 year. Additional deduction of up to Rs. 1.5 lakhs for interest paid on loan taken for an affordable house is extended till March 31st, 2021. Key highlight number 8. And this is big. Government plans to sell off a part of its holding in the LIC, that is the Life Insurance Corporation, by way of initial public offering. Now, this is the place where many of you invest in order to claim tax deductions. Key highlight number 9. Custom duty on footwear is being raised to 35% from the initial 25% and on furniture goods to 25% from 20%. This means your footwear and furniture is going to become expensive if they are imported. Key highlight number, in order to not to promote cigarettes and discourage their uses and of other tobacco products, excise duty proposed on these products is going to be raised. Key highlight number 11. new simplified return for GST from April 2020. Key highlight number 12. The FM said that the nominal GDP, that is the gross domestic product growth for 2021, is estimated at 10%. Key highlight number 13. The receipts of Government of India for 2020-2021 are estimated at rupees 22.46 lakh crore, whereas the expenditure is estimated 30 lakh 42,000 crore. The next key highlight is defense gets 3 lakh 37,000 crore as the defense budget, whereas 1 lakh 60,000 crore has been allocated to agriculture and irrigation. Also, 1 lakh 23,000 crore has been allocated for rural development and Panchayati Raj. Now, the next key highlight looks very important to me. 4,400 crore has been allocated for clean air project. Further key highlights coming from infrastructure. 5 new smart cities are to be set up via PPP model, which is the public sector and private sectors partnership. And rupees 1,70,000 crore is to be allocated to transportation. An important key highlight from telecom is rupees 6,000 crore for BharatNet program has been allocated. From fiber to home connections under BharatNet will be provided to 1 lakh gram panchayats this year itself. A new policy for private sector to build data center parks has been put in place. Key highlight from tourism. 5 archaeology sites to be developed for world-class museums are as follows. In Haryana, Rakhi Gadi. In Uttar Pradesh, Hastinapur. In Assam, Shiv Sagar. In Gujarat, Dholavira. And in Tamil Nadu, Adi Janalur. And 2,500 crore has been allocated for tourism promotion. Apart from an Indian Institute of Heritage and Conservation under Ministry of Culture is proposed, it shall have the status of a deemed university. An important update from the railways. More Tejas-like trains, tourists are to be introduced. Also, 150 new trains are to be introduced on public-private partnership basis, and 4 stations will be redeveloped with the help of this model. An important update from education. 99,300 crore has been allocated for the education sector. Rupees 3,000 crore have been allocated for skill development. Also, a United States-like SAT exam to be held in African and Asian countries for benchmarking foreign candidates who wish to study in India. Also, stay tuned for the new education policy is to be announced very soon. From agriculture, Prime Minister's Kusum scheme will be extended and expanded to 20 lakh farmers. And agriculture market is going to be more liberalized. Government proposes to handhold farmers, said the finance minister. Also, the milk processing capacity of India to be doubled to 108 ton from 53 ton by 2025. The FM also said that the fish production is to be raised to 200 lakh tons by 2022-23. Key highlights from sanitation. The government has allocated 3,60,000 to water sanitation and pipeline project and 12,300 crore for Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Key highlights from healthcare. 69,000 crore has been allocated to the healthcare sector and Rs. 35,600 crore to nutrition-related plans. A key highlight also comes from G20 Presidency Summit. Now, most of you are aware that India will be hosting the G20 Presidency Summit in 2022. For this, 100 crore is to be allocated for making preparation for this historic occasion. So, these were some of the key highlights from the Budget 2020. Dear subscribers, do you know that this year 6 million new taxpayers have been added in India? And whether you are one of them or not, please do let me know in the comments section of your views on this year's budget. Lots of blessings. Hike.